Hey guys, today I want to show you how I added an external battery to my foldable e-bike, the Fido D4S. I basically built three setups and I will show you in detail how I did it. This setup using a trunk bag is good for longer bike trips because batteries in parallel last longer and are more powerful than using them one by one. This setup is also good if you do like bike deliveries, for example, because then you will go through a lot of batteries. For commuting, I just use a single battery. As a backup, I can use a scooter bag and hang it here. This is my second setup. Then I could actually remove the rear rack. If I use this trunk bag, I cannot put my Ortlieb panniers anymore. But I could use this cheapo double over the bike style panniers, and I have a lowrider as well. This trunk bag also includes a divider, a rain cover, and these strap extenders. As batteries, I have Little Carla and Small Dan, which all contain cheap Chinese cells. I can also recommend Unit Pack Power. They also have an option for more expensive cells. I also 3D printed this small black box so I can switch between internal and the external battery. There is a bike alarm, a GPS tracker and a Samsung smart tag inside. But don't be afraid, in my first setup I just routed the cables outside so that I can connect the controller to an external battery without the switch, which is simple to do. But before I show it to you, I want to talk briefly about some important tools. Link to all bags, batteries and everything in the description. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. Also check out my blog for more information. Okay, I use a soldering iron, of course, and I also recommend to use flux. But it's really important to have something to hold the wire in place when soldering. I'm using this helping hand, but I also recommend this quick action vise to hold onto the wire so it does not go anywhere. Then I have this wire stripper and some crimping tools. This multimeter should also be able to measure the amps. A real game changer for me was to buy this hot glue gun. I can reinforce connections with it and also can make some parts kind of waterproof. I bought the cheapest gun I could find, but buy the one with more wattage because it will be faster to heat up. My first very simple setup was to route the cables from the controller and the internal battery outside the bike so that I can disconnect them and connect an external battery. I could also use the external battery in parallel to the stock battery. I put the connectors inside this neoprene armband when I didn't use them so that they are protected from the rain. This battery shell connects the internal battery to the controller. To the first step was to remove this connection and solder my own cables. I could have spliced the cable that is soldered my own cable onto the existing cable, but I wanted a clean solution, so I removed the hot glue and desoldered the old cable. I wanted to use it later to build the connection to the controller. I used AWG-14 silicone wire because it has a good flexibility and can withstand heat. I put some heat shrink, and this is actually the first time in my life I was using a hot glue gun. I put some solder first. It's important to connect two XT60 connectors so that the heat is dissipated when soldering. Here I'm actually using AMS connectors. These are nice because they have included insulation. You can buy already soldered XT60 connector cables to save some work. Links in the description. For the connection to the controller, I used the cables and connectors I salvaged from the battery shell. I put heat shrink over the connection so that everything looks tidy. I added extra cables to attach devices like bike lights, alarms, GPS, etc. I should have used thinner cables, but I had to work with what I had. I used this cheap automotive fuse to protect the devices, but firstly, I should have used an inline fuse instead, and secondly, these fuses are not meant to be soldered. That is, I should have used spade connectors. I also added this Vego clamps so that I can quickly add devices for testing. Later I will replace them with real connectors. For testing I connected the display and the external battery, and I also tried to connect the internal battery back to the controller, of course. But as you can see, always plugging in and unplugging the connectors is a little bit annoying, so I decided to build a black box with a switch next. Also to have a place to hide the bike alarm, the GPS tracker and the Samsung smart tag, I put it here in the triangle behind the controller. If you don't have a 3D printer, you can also use a small waterproof pouch or put everything in the back of your external battery. About the idea for the black box, I have to give credits to Jonas Krug, who used a similar design. This is the main body, and this is the lid with a hole for the switch. This is my second setup. I used a DPD switch. I can switch from the internal to the external battery. It's not possible to use both batteries in parallel with this design. I did not plan to do it anyways, only to use two external batteries in parallel. Note that there is some discussion whether it's dangerous to have a switch. Anyways, I would strongly recommend only switching batteries after stopping the bike and turning it off. I had to make three cables. The two cables going to the internal and external batteries are basically the same. I used spade connectors, which are common in cars and maybe not so wise to use in e-bikes. But anyways, I soldered them, so I hope it will support higher amps. Again, it's recommended to connect the XT60s so that they don't melt when soldering. I added heat shrink. This time I did not have AMS connectors. For the connection in the middle, which goes to the controller, I added extra cables to attach the bike alarm and the GPS tracker. I will not show you here how I crimped the GSD connectors. You can read about it in my blog, link in the description. Or wait for my upcoming video about my controller upgrade. Now I just had to connect the spade connectors to the DPDT switch. I put it into the 3D printed lid and used hot glue to make everything waterproof. I printed in PLA, which is not 100% waterproof, but for my use it's okay. I used the screw of the bike stand to fix the black box to the bike frame. I put the GPS tracker and the bike alarm inside and connected the internal battery and the controller. I used threaded inserts and screws to connect the 3D printed parts together. You can see here I also created an extension cable to connect the external battery. This is my setup for commuting. I used it to go to work and then I removed my rear rack and only used the lowrider in front. One problem I had with this setup was that one small little color battery was not strong enough for mountains. It could not deliver enough amps for my powerful KT controller. For example, on a bike trip, the battery just shutted the bike off on a longer steep incline. That's why I bought this trunk bag to put two batteries in parallel for longer bike trips. This is also the perfect setup if you're doing deliveries. When putting two batteries in parallel, it's important to first charge them separately so they have the same voltage. My first battery has 40.97 volts and my second battery has also 40.97 volts, which is perfect. I could now charge my batteries in parallel, but since the second battery would be charged through the discharge board, there would be no overvoltage protection. So since I'm extra careful, I plan to unplug the parallel connections and charge them separately. Also, it's faster to charge with two chargers at the same time. Just note that, as I said, with the current design of my switch, it's not possible to use the external batteries and the stock battery all in parallel. I would need to go back to my first setup or redesign my switch. So I hope this video was helpful for you. Please don't hesitate to post in the comments if you have any question, and also check out my blog because there I describe everything in detail. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Links to all bags, batteries, tools and everything in the description. See you next time, bye!